weather caused some big problems at BWI today.
It certainly did. According to the FAA, lightning struck the control tower, bringing the airport to a standstill and sending one worker to shock trauma. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live at the airport with one of our two big stories that we're following tonight. George.
Well, Donna, that worker is an air traffic controller. We're told he's going to be okay, but this day boils down to a freak accident shutting down a major airport for hours. John Dunkerley, the air traffic controller's union representative at BWI Airport, says an air traffic controller inside the tower was shocked by lightning when a bolt hit the top of the tower around 2:20 this afternoon.
As far as we know, when the lightning hit the tower, it traveled through a panel and came to an ungrounded piece of equipment and arced over and hit the personnel as he was reaching over to turn on an engine generator.
Dunkerley says the jolt of electricity knocked the controller to the ground. He felt numb, so he was taken to shock trauma. Dunkerley says he's been released.
The chances of it happening while he's reaching over to turn on a piece of equipment, the exact same time that lightning's hitting the tower, he should play the lottery.
As a safety precaution after the strike, an FAA official says the tower shut down to make sure no equipment was damaged. After safely landing planes in the immediate vicinity, the tower dropped communication with all the planes and turned over the airspace to a regional tower near D.C. Incoming flights thereafter were diverted to other airports. For more than 2 hours, no planes landed or took off from BWI, while Dunkerley says engineers checked the tower and grounded the equipment that he says should have been so before the storm. Flights resumed gradually around 5:30 p.m. to the delight of thousands of delayed travelers.
I travel a lot, so this is right up there in my top two of crazy things that have happened. So.
And those residual delays have diminished greatly because the airport says right now two of its main runways are back open. We're live at the airport. George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.